The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 29, 1977, in Bombay, India.
The real problem of life is not to adjust things materially, change from one form of government to another form of government. These things are temporary. It will not give relief. And this fighting between one party with another amongst the politicians or the kshatriyas or the administrators, they are going on perpetually. That is not a very new thing. So, we should not forget our real life. But ruling over to get political predominance, that may be fine. That is natural. It is going on, just like the battle of Kurukshetra. It is a fighting between two sections of the same family. Who is ruled over? So there was fighting, but at the same time, they did not lose Krishna culture. That is the important point. Similarly, India has got a great culture background, Vedic culture or Krishna culture. Vedic culture means Krishna culture, and Krishna culture means Vedic culture. Vedaścha sarvai ahameva bhedyam. Study Veda or Vedanta means to understand Krishna. That is the purpose. Vedaścha sarvai. Veda means knowledge, and Anta means end. Vedanta. Vyasadeva, Srila Vyasadeva, he has given us the Vedanta philosophy. What is the purpose? That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarvasacaham ridishannivishtya mattas mitijnanam apohanancha. Vedaścha sarvai ahameva bhedyam. Vedanta vid vedanta kritcha aham. So, we should take care of very seriously about this culture of Bhagavad Gita. This is India's property. This Vedic culture, the instruction of Bhagavad Gita was spoken on the land of Bharatvarsha, although it is not meant for a particular class of men or a class of people or in a particular country. It is meant for everyone. Manushyanam sahasyeshu kaschid yadati sita. Especially for the human being. So, our request is that we may fight amongst ourselves for political predominance, but why should we forget our real culture, Vedic culture, Krishna consciousness? That is our request. All important men leaders of the society, they should take this Vedic culture, Krishna consciousness, and not only preach in their own country, but all over the world. If you don't take it, there is a great reason. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Asatva dhara purusha dharmasya saparantapa mam aprapva eva nivartante mitra sangharo atmani. Krishna says, personally, he comes, jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bhara tada atmanam sujam. For the benefit of the human society, because dharmasya glani, dharma is meant for the human society. Dharma is not meant for the cats and dogs. They are no good. You cannot have any religious principle or an institution in the cat society or dog society. Dharmena hina pasabhi sohana. Therefore, when human society becomes devoid of dharma, then it is animal society. It is no longer human society. And what is the dharma? Actual time spoken. Dharmantu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Dharma means the law or the words given by the Supreme Personality of God. That is all. That is the shortcut definition of dharma. You should do this, you should not do it. Just like the government gives us law, keep to the right. So that is law, although it is a very simple thing. Give to the right. But that is law. Similarly, what Krishna said, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If we take it for proper utilization of this great boon of life, human form of life, then we become dharmic and our life is successful. So what Krishna said, that is not at all difficult. Even a child can perform. What Krishna said, manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji manga namaskuru. Very simple thing. Krishna says, always think of me. What is the difficulty? Even a child can think of Krishna. If he goes to the temple and if he understands from his parents that here is the deity Krishna, he's impressed. He understands here is Krishna because he is simple. So he can also think of Krishna. I went to the temple, I saw Krishna, very nicely dressed, very nicely decorated, very nice foodstuff was offered, and I got the prasadam. Where is the difficulty? Manvana bhavamad bhakta. And if you go regularly to see Krishna in the temple and to remember him, then you become a bhakta. It doesn't require that you have to pass an examination to become a bhakta, or you have to become a very learned scholar. Because that is the end of knowledge. Vedaishta sarvai, aham eva veda. If you simply understand Krishna, your all Vedic knowledge is perfect. Ārādhita jadi harīs tamasā tatat kim. if you have understood Hari, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, tapasa tatakti, then where is the necessity of tapasya? You have achieved the result of tapasya. Because to understand Krishna is not so easy. Manasana sahasesu kasti jadati siddhaye jadatam abhisiddhyanam kasti bhitimam tato. To understand Krishna, he requires great tamasya. There is no doubt about it. But if somewhere or other you have understood Krishna, then Aradhita Jadivari is tapasa tatattim. There is no more need of tapasya. Your ultimate goal of life is already achieved. And Naradhita Jadi Haris Tapasa Tatakim. And you have performed great austerities, penance, but you do not know what is Krishna. Then it is useless, waste of time. Naradhita Jadi Haris Tapasa Tatakim. What is the value of your tapasya? Real thing you do not understand. The Aradhita Jadi Haris Tapasa Tatakim. Naradhita Jadi Haris Tapasat. Antabhahi Jadi Haris Tapasat Atav Kim. If you have learned these four principles as instructed by Bhagavan, Manmana Bhavod Bhakta Madhyari Mangala Maskuru, very simple thing. Antabhahi, within and without, if you have learned to think of Krishna, antat-mahi-jari-haris tapasātata, then where is the use of tapasya? It is already achieved. Because you are thinking always externally and internally, Krishna. Nārādhita-jari-haris. Nāntat-mahi-jari-haris tapasātata. If you have not learned the art of thinking Krishna externally and internally, then what is the use of your so-called tapasya? So this Krishna consciousness movement is very easy. If it cannot be introduced, I mean to say, in large scale, collectively, individually, anyone can learn and take the benefit. Anyone, even a child, manmana bhava madhava. And what is the result? The result is mameva ishyasi, asamsaya. Anyone who is doing this, asamsaya, without any doubt, you are coming to me. That is the involvement. How to go back home, back to God. Not to join here in the dog's race. That is not him. It will not make me happy, anyone happy. Pragite kriyamarani gunai karmani sarvasa. Ahamkara vimumratma kartaham iti mannat. The nature's law is working very stringently. You cannot avoid. Daivijesa gunavai mamamaya durattaya. Māmevaja prapadyante, māyāmetāntaram. So these things are there. I can quote many verses like that. But Krishna consciousness is very easy and everyone should become Krishna conscious. That is the aim of life. Nate vidu sarthagatenhi Vishnu durasayaji bahirathamani. We are trying to adjust things externally, but that will never be fulfilled. Durasaya. This is hope against hope. You cannot do anything independently because you are fully under the clutches of Maya. Brahman Sarvabhutani Jantra Rurali Maya Ishara Sarvabhutanam Riddeshe Arjuna Tishtati. Krishna said, my dear Arjuna, Ishara, the Supreme Lord, is situated in the core of everyone's heart. He's not far away. And he's observing. In the Upanishad it is said that there are two birds on one tree. One is eating the fruit and the other is witnessing. The witnessing bird is Krishna and the eating bird is the jiva. So Krishna is so friendly that he always lives with us just to turn our face towards Krishna. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati. What is his business? He's simply waiting for the time when we shall turn our face to Krishna. That is his business. But unfortunately, we do not want Krishna. We want something which is not Krishna. That is our difference. Pristine Krishna is giving us facility. Brahman sarvutani jantra rurani maya. Krishna gives intelligence, matta smriti jnanam apohanancha, that you are my part and parcel. Why you are struggling so hard in this material world? Come to me. I will give you all protection. Aham tva sarva paapi bhama khushya. He is ready. But I will not. That's my obstination. At that time what Krishna will do? He is affectionate father. All right. What do you want to do? I want to do. All right. Brahman sarvabhutani jantra rurani maya. He immediately orders patiti, maya dhakshena patiti suyate sacharacharam. This living entity wants a body like this. So give him a body like that. Jantra. That is called jantra. It is a machine. This body is a machine. And therefore we are changing one body to another. Jantra rurhanima. This is our business. So, if I am now in a jantra, Mercedes car, and suppose next life I ride on another jantra, which is four-legged dog, then what is the benefit of this kind of struggle for existence? But that is going on. Therefore Krishna warns, asadvadhana purusha dharma shasaparam mama prapu. The aim of life was to achieve me, Krishna says. But the result is, because he does not hear what I say, mama prapu nivartanti, again goes back. Mrityu saṃsāra vatmani. This material world means to take birth and die. That is called mrityu saṃsāra. Now I am born as Indian or as Brahmin or something like that. The next life, there is no guarantee. Krishna does not say that there is guarantee. Krishna says, tatha dehantara prapti. You have to change your body. Tatha dehantara prapti dhirastatata mahiyati. So, our request is that such a great science of for the human society, for understanding the problems of life, how to solve it, how to achieve the greatest success in life. We have got this in the Bhagavad Gita. Why should we neglect it? What is the reason? Other things may go on. This political fight or some fight. Fighting, this is the world of fight. Agamapaina anitya tangati thikkasya bhar. Matras parsast kaunti or sitasna sukadukkada. This is world of sitasna sukadukkada. You cannot have all. So tangati thikkasya bhar. Just try to tolerate. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also says the same thing. Trinadapi sunitena, tarorapi sahishnana, amanina mananena, kitanina sadahari. We have to become tolerant than the grass on the street and forgetting more than the tree. In this way, we have to tolerate whatever is going on in this material world. Tolerate does not mean unnecessarily we shall suffer. As far as possible, let us struggle. But we should not forget our real business. That is human life. Real business is that I am part and parcel of God. Moi vāṅsu jīvu. Somehow or other, I am fallen in this material condition. There is a Bengali poet, he has sung, Anadi karma phale puri bhavar navajale, tori vare nadeki upa. Somehow or other, I am fallen in this material ocean and struggling for existence. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore prays. He does not pray for any material benefit. He is teaching us nadhanangana janangana sundaring kavitanga about Jagadish kama. My Lord, Jagadish, I do not want any material happiness or wealth. Nadhanangana janam are great followers. Na sundaring kavita, or beautiful wife. These are the demands of the kurmis. I must have wealth, I must have position, I must have beautiful home, beautiful wife. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu denies. He says, nadhanangana janangana sundaring kavita bhajagadishakam. He does not want even mukti. Because he says next line that Mama Janvani Janvani Ishari Bhavata Bhakti Rahitaki Sri. Life after life, simply let me remain your devotee. Ai Nandatanuja Patitanking Karanga Mama Bhishame Havambudo. Kripaya Tabapada Pankaja Sthita Dulisadisham Vichit. So you have got such vast knowledge for achieving the goal of life. It is India. Why should we neglect? Why we should become so foolish that forget our real purpose of life and engage in will-o'-the-wisp struggle for existence, which will never be successful? Why this misconception of life? At least there must be this institution of Krishna consciousness in India, so that not only the Indians, but all outside India, they should come and learn what is Krishna consciousness. So, it is already explained, we are trying to develop this institution in Bombay. Bombay is the best city in India. And people are also very advanced and enlightened. So let us combine together and develop this institution for the whole human society. That is our ambition. It is not for any sect or any creed or any particular class of man. Marusalam Sahu. It is for the human society, and we have got this opportunity of human body. A Bengali poet sings, Hari Hari Bi Phale Janama Gwainu Manusra Janama Paiya Radha Krishna Nabhodiya Janiya Suniya Bishukhai. My Lord, I have wasted this valuable life, human form of life, because I did not take to Krishna consciousness. So, if we do not take Krishna consciousness seriously in this human form of life, then we must know that you are drinking poison knowingly. Don't neglect. Try to understand. It is based on science, philosophy, shastra, knowledge. It is not a blind faith. And we are prepared to answer you in any way. The method is very simple. Even a child can take advantage of it. Not that we are manufacturing. It is sanctioned in the shastra. Kalo dosu nidhi raja, hi asti eko mahanagna. This is a statement by Sukadeva Goswami, Maharaj Parikshit. He describes the faults of this Kali Yuga. It is just like the ocean. Kalo dosu nidhi raja, hi asti eko mahanagna. But there is one very great advantage, he said. What is that? Kītanāleva krishnasya mukta saṅga param braje. If you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then you become free from all contamination and go back to home, back to God. Thank you very much.